Hello viewers, welcome to my channel Pharmacypedia. In this session, we are going to learn about the regulatory requirements and the approval procedures for new drugs. So new drug regulatory requirements are different from the generic drugs. So let us try to understand what are new drug applications. New drug applications are the basically applications submitted to the individual regulatory authorities for the authorization to market a new drug. So as the name indicates, new drug application, it is meant for the new drug only, which is having the innovative product. Now to gain this permission, a sponsor first has to submit the preclinical and the clinical test data for analyzing the drug informations, descriptions of the manufacturing trials. So let us, before beginning to the actual regulatory requirements, for my dear students, first I want to make you clear about the difference between the generic drug development and the new drug development. When we talk about the generic drug development, it takes place once a patent has been expired, then any manufacturer can manufacture the product. In the case of the new drug development, since the product is coming into the market for the first time, it has to go through a thorough process of the drug discovery and development. So when we talk about the generic development, what happens is that a drug is already in the market for many years, so there is no need to conduct for the clinical trials. So, but in the case of new drug development, new drug approvals, the authority seeks relevant safety and efficacy clinical trials data, clinical studies data in laboratory, and goes through the clinical studies data to ensure that the new drug which will be going to the market is totally safe and efficacious. For that, the sponsor, the manufacturer, has to first conduct the clinical trials. They have to take into account the detailed preclinical and clinical test data analysis, and that data is along with the application form has to be submitted with the new drug application, then it will be reviewed by the regulatory agencies. In India, the regulatory agency is the CDSCO, Central Drug Control Organization. So the CDSCO, Central Drug Standard Control Organization. So CDSCO is the central organization working along with the state regulatory agencies for the application of new drug products. So if you consider the process and the cycle of the regulation for the new drug, after the drug discovery, drug development and manufacturing, this actually refers to the formulation development. Your new drug molecule has been discovered, it goes through the optimization process, it goes through the formulation process, it goes through the development process, pre-formulation process, it goes through everything. And once it has been developed into a optimized dosage forms, it have to go through the clinical trials. Now clinical trials have to be conducted in different stages and different phases. So there is again a regulatory requirement which is looking after the conduction of the clinical trials. The Schedule Y of the Drugs and Cosmetic Acts have all the provisions for the conducting of the clinical trials. Clinical trials initially were not that much regulated in India, but in current scenario, there is a they are very well developed. The plan has been very well chalked out, and every manufacturer who wants the NDA have to first conduct the clinical trials in different phases, and it is very important part of the drug discovery process. After that, only the once the successful clinical trials have been conducted, preclinical studies have been conducted, then the manufacturer can apply for the marketing authorization application to the regulatory agencies. In India, the regulatory process, since it is regulated by the CDSCO, Central Drug Standard Control Organization, and state regulatory authorities, so the data in online process have to be submitted to these agencies. So we were discussing that in new drug development, we need the detailed clinical trial studies data. But in the case of generic development, we don't need that clinical data since the drug is already existing in the market for prolonged time. It has already been proven to be safe and efficacious. So when we talk about, this is the major difference between generic development and new drug development. So when we talk about the new drug development, you have to undergo the clinical trials. So as I was discussing in in the previous slide also, clinical trials have to be conducted in a sequential manner in different phases. For example, they have to be initiated with the preclinical studies, which is being followed by the phase 1 clinical trials, followed by the phase 2, which is known as the exploratory trials, then followed by the phase 3, which is the confirmatory trials, and finally followed by the phase 4. Phase 4 is basically the post-marketing approval. Once the if the phase 3 data is fine and the marketing authorization license is being granted, although the medicament may reach, the drug approval is being granted, the medicament will reach to the market, but that will be considered into the phase 4, that is the post-marketing approval trials. Nowadays, when we talk about the application for the new drug approval from the regulatory agencies, it has to be in certain form of the documentation to the regulatory authorities. The regulatory authorities need the data in a form of the dossier known as the common technical documents. So in this document, it has been segregated. Documents have to be sequentially arranged in the form of a CTD dossiers. So the dossier is divided into 5 modules. The module 1 contains the administrative information, the applicant's information, the drug product to be registered, that information in detail, followed by the module 2. Module 2 is basically referring to the quality overall summary. So it is the summarization of all the modules from module 3, module 4, module 5. So since it refers to the quality overall summary, it comprises of the gist of the complete dossier. Module 3 is about the quality product, quality part. Quality part basically refers from initial day 1 to the finalization day study in a gist way, in a sequential way. So whatever product development have been done or whatever studies have been conducted on the pharmaceutical ingredients, on the excipients, on the interactions, on the development, on the validation have to be included in the module 3 quality part. Now this is again very important, module 4 and module 5. Module 4 are basically comprising of the non-clinical studies and module 5 comprises of the clinical studies. So they are very important in the case of new drug development. Module 4 and module 5 are the, you can see, backbone of the new drug approval process. So their data have to be conducted in a very safety and efficacious way, and if only found to be positive, if only found to be totally safe, then only the license would be granted for the new drug development. Next, we move on to the regulations which govern the approval process. So as I was talking about a new drug approval process, the drug has to be first proven to be safe and efficacious after conducting successful clinical trials. The regulations which governs the CDSCO is the Drug and Cosmetic Act 1940 and the Rules 1945, which were proclaimed by the India's Parliament to regulate the import, manufacture, distribution and sale of drugs and cosmetics. Now the CDSCO and the office of its leader, the Drug Controller General, was established. In 1988, the Indian government added again Schedule Y. This is again very important for the new drug approval process. Schedule Y to the Drug and Cosmetic Acts 1940 and Rules 1945. Schedule 5 actually provides the guidelines and the requirements for conducting the clinical trials, which was further reviewed in 2005 to bring it to par at the worldwide recognized procedure. Basically what happened was that initially clinical trial were not, guidelines were not that much established, but as the time proceeded, when you have to be stand at par with the worldwide recognized procedures, they were, the act was amended, and now the clinical trials have to be conducted in a sequential manner. Clinical trial registry is there. CDSCO looks after it in a very serious manner, and only after getting adequate approvals the trials can only be conducted in India. So when we talk about the rules of the Drugs and Cosmetics Act 1940 and the Rules 1945, the clinical trials first can be registered at the Clinical Trial Registry of India. This registry is being maintained, which gives the detail of the clinical trials and the subjects involved in the trials. Now there are certain rules which needs to be followed as per the Schedule Y of Drugs and Cosmetic Act. First is the Rule 122A. This is specifically for the application for permission to import a new drug in India. So whenever any new drug has to be imported in India, it has to be in compliance with the Rule 122. Then Rule 122B is for the application for approval to manufacture new drug other than the drug specified under Schedule C and C1. Rule 122D is basically for getting the permission to import or manufacture the fixed dose combinations. Rule 122DA refers to the applications for permission to conduct the clinical trials for new drugs or investigational new drugs, INDs. Then Rule 122DAB refers to the compensation in the case of injury or death during the clinical trials. So when we talk about the investigational drug, new drugs, the sponsor needs to provide the detailed information to the DCGI about the generic name, patent status, brief description of the physicochemical, biological properties, technical information related to stability, specifications of the drug, manufacturing process, worldwide regulatory status, animal pharmacology and toxicity studies. So for any investigational new drug, apart from that, you also need to submit the data about the published clinical trial reports, proposed protocols and performers, trial duration, drug master files, undertaking to report serious or life-threatening adverse reactions, if any, observed during the clinical trials. So all this information, all these data have to be submitted along with the application for new drug approvals or investigational new drugs. So there are different stages in which they have to be submitted. The very first stage involves about the submission of the clinical trial application for evaluating the safety and efficacy. Since in the case of new drug approvals, the clinical studies are very important. So module 4-5 has to be conducted. First, it has to be submitted at the clinical trial submission registry process. Then after that, the requirements for permission of a new drug approval has to be obtained. After that, only the post-approval changes in the biological products, the quality, safety and efficacy of the documents needs to be checked out, and preparation for the next stage comprises of the preparation of the quality information for drug submission for new drug approvals. So it has these are in this sequence only the drug approval process takes place. So this is the main chart depicting the drug approval process in India. The applicant has to apply for the new drug approvals for investigational new drug applications by filing it to CDSCO headquarters, which is then examined by the new drug division department, followed by the detailed review by the IND committees, and then recommendations from DCGI have to be received. So once after the IND application has been approved, clinical trials can be initiated. So once the clinical trials have been conducted successfully, application for the new drug registration is then reviewed by DCGI, and if found to be complete in accordance and conduction of successful clinical trials only, then if the license is granted. In the case of new drug approvals, apart from if it is not belonging to the IND category, if it is like new drug approval, then application to the ethical committee has to be taken, and report of the ethical committee has to be provided within 12 weeks, and if found to be positive, clinical trials can be conducted. So there are two processes. One is through the IND route and another one is from the new drug approval route. And if the if it is being found that the application is not complete, then there would be refusal to grant the license. So there may be three conditions. First is the application may be refused, application may be recommended with certain changes, and the application license is granted. So in all of them, the decision process takes around 12 to 18 months. Thank you so much for watching my video. Please do like, share and subscribe to my channel Pharmacypedia for keeping me continuously motivated, and please support. Thank you so much, everyone.